Before I would like to welcome you all to this live webinar from Talent Battle. Okay, I am Ajinkya Kulkarni, co-founder of Talent Battle, where we help students with job placement preparation. We are a one-stop placement preparation platform for the students, where we help with aptitude, general, technical, and interview preparation. We were getting a lot of requests from students because they want to start with the career in risk management, information security, disaster recovery, business analyst. So we had some contacts in the industry. So we are really fortunate to have some of the industry experts today, those who are going to guide you with the webinar. And they are going to discuss various career opportunities. What are the trends right now in the market? So first of all, I would like to welcome Shibhyanshu Sharma, who is currently working as Vice President of Risk Management at SBI Life Insurance Company Limited. Welcome, sir. And I would also like to welcome Aniket Kulkarni, who is currently working as a manager of enterprise risk management and business continuity management at SBI Life Insurance. Welcome, Aniket, sir. Yeah. So now, without wasting time, okay, I would like to hand over to Shibhyanshu, sir. Okay, so he can start with the session. I would like to just mention two or three instructions to all the viewers. Okay, those who have registered for the session, they are going to get the certificate. So don't worry about it. At the end of the session, I'll be posting the link. I'll be opening that live chat. So where you can post, where you can submit your attendance, then you will get the certificate for the session. At the end, I will also open the chat box where you can ask the doubts directly to these industry experts. Okay, so sir, now you can start with sharing the screen.
Yeah, good afternoon all. So screen share now?
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, good afternoon all. Good afternoon engineers. Yet to become engineers and the process of becoming engineer or who are already engineers. We are here from industry of risk management, business continuity, information and data security to tell you guys what is the requirement this industry is facing right now and where engineers can fit. How we are finding difficult to get a talent of engineer pool because engineers are not very much aware of this demand in this arena. So just I'll be discussing this in detail in my presentation. Along with me, my colleague, Mr. Aniket Kulkarni will be there. And we guys will take you through the presentation. So before that, there is a disclaimer, Aniket.
Yeah, so guys, just one small disclaimer. Whatever opinions which we are expressing in this particular PPT, those are solely us. These are our personal opinion, analysis and conclusion. If you want to use this part, any information in this PPT, you need to take the permission of us and Talent Battle. Thank you. Next.
The entire presentation we'll be dividing into three parts, the entire core agenda of this, to make you guys aware what all career opportunities are there in different segments of risk management, whether it be enterprise risk management, whether it be information security, cyber security, data protection, business continuity, disaster recovery, business analyst, in this domain, risk analytics, risk engineering, where all these demands are there and where an engineer can fit it himself or herself into. Then we'll be talking about the recruiting companies and pay scale, career growth in these type of jobs. And we also tell how engineering students can prepare themselves to land a job in these fields. What is there right now that there are international certifications? There are not many Indian certifications. So what is happening? Engineers are doing MBA. They are then taking these international certification. And in this process, they are taking around 5 to 7 years. And then they make themselves fit for coming into this arena. So my request and my earnest suggestion to all my engineering friends that please go through this presentation and discussion in detail and get to know where all you can fit yourself. And talking about the career opportunities, we are from life insurance company, life insurance industry. There are 24 life insurance companies in India. Similarly, there are more than 30 general insurance companies. So only in insurance segment, there are more than 54. And each of these companies have their risk management department. And all of them require engineers, at least 5 to 6 engineers in each company. Then comes, there are different service sector, banking, mutual fund, non-banking financial companies, manufacturing companies, all these companies, the risk management department require engineers. A lot of opportunities are there. We'll talk this in detail. Before that, my friend Aniket will tell you why after COVID, this is very much required. Aniket.
Yeah. So guys, every day, every other day, we are hearing news about COVID. We all are very in a fearful stage. The uncertainty is very much. But trust me, guys, even though we are in a very difficult times, but our future is very, very bright. So what will be the world after the COVID? What will be the job market? What are the skill sets which will be required after this COVID? Next. So guys, one thing is for sure, competition is there. It will be there. Rather, it will rise to multifold. Many global economists have suggested that recession will be there. So engineers need to develop a proper strategy. For that, the first step is to survive and then prosper. For survival, the first thing is to get job. For getting job, they need to identify what are the unexplored areas where engineers are in high demand. One more thing in this particular aspect, companies will prefer, because of the COVID, every company is going for the cost cutting. So companies will prefer the already trained individuals compared to the untrained people. So my request is you need to upgrade, upskill yourself. You need to get yourself trained. You need to identify what are the future jobs which will be in demand in the next 5 to 10 years down the line. So guys, invest in yourself, invest in training, upgrade yourself, upskill yourself so that you will reap the benefits in the future. Next. So guys, so when we say the top trending skills which are required, if you see the 2020, the top three skills, that is the complex problem solving, critical thinking and creativity. Guys, who other than engineers will do this? Engineers are the best complex problem solvers. They are the critical thinkers. They have the analytical mind and they're the best in creativity. So you need to use these skills. Next. Along with this, the soft skills. When we say the soft skills, these are some of the soft skills which every engineer needs to understand and get acquainted with. That is the stress management, conflict management, building relationship, etc., etc. Next.
So coming to what all the requirements of this risk management industry is right now. So let us refer top trending skills in India as per Michael Page Salary Benchmark for 2020. This report is developed in 1920. Even some part of the COVID is considered in this. The top trends are artificial intelligence, machine learning, risk management, information security, business continuity and disaster management, data privacy and data protection. What are these fields? Talking about artificial intelligence and machine learning, you guys are well aware. Everybody is talking about this. Even the companies of BFSI, banks, manufacturing, they are also going into AI and ML through risk management. They are doing the process, the entire process of them, which was earlier manual, is going through AI and ML, and risk management is doing a peculiar role in this. Then risk management. Earlier, everything used to be done face-to-face, one-on-one, but COVID has given us an opportunity, everything digital. Work from home. That's why risk management work has come very much. We are doing online branch risk assessments, everything online. We are developing softwares. The engineers in my departments whom we have taken after they completed MBA and all, because they got to know about this field after that only. We have taken them and they are developing softwares. They have developed our operation risk management software on which everything is done online. We have done that. Information security. Data is a topic, data is information these days, and their security is very much important. Aadhaar Act, Government of India has given a lot of IT Act and all on information security. You must have seen what has happened to the Facebook and others. You must have understood what is going on in the TikTok battle. Yesterday only, US was also planning to ban. UK has banned it. India has banned it. All because of information security. Because what you are sharing in TikTok, everything is going to a different country. So that's why government has banned. So why this information security is very much important, and computer engineer knows very much how to curtail those things. Network software engineer knows how to have network operation centers in information security done. What is a deception technology in this? Everything gets to know. Business continuity disaster management. The era, March 2020 has given us in India COVID, because in March only we started lockdown and companies started working from home under business continuity. They have to continue their business. We also continued our business, all life insurance sector. They were able to almost not as good as quarter one of 1920 business, but they were about almost, they achieved their Q1 of last year's business, this Q1 also, because of the business continuity and disaster management. And again, everybody is depending upon those engineers who is working day in, day out through their VPN, virtual private network, VDIs, and various other activity softwares, which is giving them a lot of career opportunities. Then comes data privacy and data protection. I'll talk this in detail. European Union has come in 2018 with a regulation of GDPR, wherein they have told that all member of European Union country, they will be protected under this. And any company who will leak data directly or indirectly, knowingly or unknowingly, will be fined as high as 4% of their total gross revenues. Similarly, Indian government is coming with the protection, Personal Data Protection Act. This is under parliament, under discussion. And one of the Sabha, Lok Sabha has also passed it. And I'm still in discussion with a group of ministers. And very soon it will be an act. It will, right now it's a bill, and it will be an act. And that act, or a bill right now, it's talking about not only 4% fine, but also jail term for company's owner, for company's MD and CEO, if data gets leaked. So think about a service company, think of a bank who are dealing with all the important information of a customer, all financial information of a customer. If any data gets leaked from them, what will happen? Yesterday in Kerala, the Kerala Electric Power Company, the state power company, they lost data of their customer. If this act will come, they will be fined, even the heads will roll down. So to protect this data, to make circumvent the entire information of this data, we require engineers. And actually engineers are working on, but supply of these engineers are very, very less. Demand is huge, but supply is very less. We'll talk through case studies of our experience also, how we found it very difficult to find engineers. So starting with the risk management, how engineers can do. But before that, I'll take what risk management is. It is plan-based business strategy that aims to identify, assess, and prepare for any dangers, hazards, and other potential for disaster, both physical, figurative, quantitative, qualitative, that may interfere with an organization's operations and objectives. My objective is to have no fraud. If a customer of life insurance industry approaches our branch, there should not be any fraud. He should not be missold. He should not be told that he will be giving this and he gets something else. And if after his death or something happens untoward to that customer, his family member comes to us for taking claim, there should not be any fraud. But how to curtail this fraud? We require fraud analytics. We require softwares to handle all this. We require a pattern to know what type of fraud is happening in the past, what type of fraud will happen in the future. All this Manually is not possible. We handle close to SBI bank handles close to 42 crore savings account. Is it possible manually to check all? No, we require softwares. So that's why we require in this domain engineers. And ERM provides a framework for risk management, which typically involves identifying particular events or circumstances relevant to the organization's objectives, threat and opportunities, assessing them in terms of likelihood, magnitude of impact, determining a mitigation strategy and monitoring process. We have developed the entire ERM framework in one software, in-house software, and we took help of almost 6 engineers in this. We have to search for these engineers. In this slide, we have given 2 logo. There is a logo of RIMS, the Risk Management Society. Whenever you get time, browse what is RIMS? It's a US-based organization present in more than 70 countries. Lot of job opportunities they give. There is a job bank. IRM, in the left, you must have seen the logo of IRM, Institute of Risk Management, UK. Another big society of risk management based out of London, giving lot of opportunities to risk professionals. And risk professionals having engineering background have lot of scope here. What type of scope is there in risk management? A scope of risk analyst, analytical brain, a critical thinking brain. An engineer has 4 years of rigorous training they have gone through. They have that statistical domain. They have that actuarial domain. They have mathematics in them. They know how to analyze. Operational risk manager. We recommend to take operational risk manager with an engineering background. Risk reporter, risk engineer, manufacturing sector. My friend, he is head of ERM in Thermax in Pune, and he requires a lot of risk engineers. He hardly gets any. I recommend him that you can refer these. And you know, these, we take them their background of engineering after 6-7 years. They have done this job in Accenture and all, and then they come to us. So there is a lot of demand. Supply is very less. That's why package is high. And risk consultant. Big force are there. Other companies in consultancy are there. Protiviti and all. They require risk consultants. Search, you will get a lot of such these name jobs. Search in LinkedIn, you'll get a lot of demand. The next area is information cybersecurity. My friend Aniket will take. Aniket.
Yes, guys. So we all know that information and cybersecurity is one of the most trending skills. Every day we are listening news of this particular bank is getting hacked. This particular accounts, personal accounts are being stolen. So now, guys, everything is going online. Everything is going digital. The demand for information and cybersecurity candidates or engineers are rising. You need to see that the information and cybersecurity domain, in this information domain majorly deals with all types of information. Cybersecurity majorly deals with cyber domain or the cyberspace, that is the internet space or the electronic space. Even though the network administrator or software developers, coding and testers, these type of jobs are common and well known. But the jobs in this particular domain, that is the information and cybersecurity, is slowly rising, but the demand is very much. Engineers need to identify this demand. Next. When we say the job profiles, these are some of the common job profiles which the major IT companies, major consultancy companies, and other big companies are offering. The most common and the most trending among them is the ISO 27001. ISO 27001 is an information security standard. The implementation of information security with the help of ISO 27001, its audit, is the most trending and most sought out skill to look for. The big four consultants, Ernst & Young, KPMG, Deloitte, Protiviti, and many other big consultants, they're looking for engineers in this domain. Other profiles, like for example, security analyst, security engineer, they're responsible for the vulnerability analysis, penetration testing, etc., etc. IT risk is one of the most important risks in the enterprise risk area. Next.
Coming to the third segment of career opportunities for engineers is business continuity and disaster recovery. Each of the companies have a disaster recovery site. All of the companies, all banks, all insurance companies, all mutual fund companies, they have to have disaster recovery site. What is disaster recovery site? Head office is located at one place. There is a data center of that office. There should be a disaster recovery site of that head office. What if there is an earthquake in that location where head office is located? Is it possible that if a global organization having a head office at Mumbai gets an earthquake and nothing happens to in globally of that organization if earthquake hit Mumbai? No, it's not possible. The company has to run, bank has to transact. From where? That is disaster recovery. From alternate site, which may be different country, different continent, different state in India. That is there. And how to have this structure in place? Engineers are there to make this work. Disaster recovery places. Business continuity. We have seen, I gave an example. In 2 days' time, on 11th of March, 2020, WHO told that Corona is a pandemic. By 12th, each and every companies have invoked their business continuity in India. All banks, all insurance companies, all manufacturing companies, all IT companies, everybody. Colleague of mine, friend of mine, she's there, ERM head in Infosys. All Infosys offices, everything got under business continuity from 12th March. How they have created this infrastructure? Through organizational resilience, through crisis and disaster management. This structure was in place earlier. Who will be called? When the meeting will happen? Who will coordinate for the meeting? What actionable meeting will do? What will be the implementation points? How this infrastructure will be created? Everything is done 24 hours time. Because we have prepared ourselves for such disaster in the past. We prepared ourselves for earthquake. We prepared ourselves for terrorist attacks, especially in Mumbai and all. We prepared ourselves for terrorist attacks. But for pandemic also, we did it this time. And almost all companies were successful. And engineers played a very big role. I give example, Tums, VP and VDI. My friend Aniket, he was in charge. In a day's time, he got transferred for a time being from ERM to a business continuity vertical because he was an engineer. We had less number of engineers in that vertical. Because of his background, we have to transfer him. He managed it very well. We managed the entire crisis because with the help of engineers. What type of job profiles they get here? They get business continuity professional, business continuity analyst. Before a disaster strike, the assessment of that, what will happen? How many systems they will affect? If there is an attack, what will happen? How to work? How to continue our work? How a customer like Ajinkya will get a SBI transaction done? We should be having that done. We cannot say that SBI is under cyber attack and we will not do the transactions. It's not possible. We will get a lot of fines, even jail term. So we have to continue. And that's why we require an entire infrastructure and scaffolding of analysts to be there, having a background of engineering. And now, right now, we are getting MBAs. MBAs like myself. I am an MBA, MBA risk management. I got into this. Niket is MBA risk management with an engineer. He got into this. But we require engineers. Disaster recovery analyst. How to recover as fast as possible. Business continuity and disaster recovery tester. All system to be working in place. All application of ours. All softwares of ours. From alternate side. Testing of that. Coding of everything to create an infrastructure of that. Who will do? Engineers. and with all these BCM consultants, because they will get to know what is the entire thing. A lot of BCI UK, Business Continuity Institute UK, they came last year in India. They started their office in Mumbai, Bangalore. They wanted to take engineers and all. Then we referred a few and they got. But again, whom we are referring? We are referring an engineer with 12 years of experience in this domain, and then clearing some examination of ISACA and all. And then they come into information security. Why they are not doing at starter? That is okay. Next domain, Aniket.
Yes. So guys, there is a proverb. Data is the new oil. Such is the importance of data. Be it customer data, be it our own organization's data. Safeguarding the data and protection of data is of utmost importance. So this data protection discipline or domain deals with safeguarding important information from corruption, compromise, or loss. The importance of data protection increases as the amount of data being created. Every other day, with the help of social media or with any type of media, the data is being created. So this protection and safeguarding of this data, this domain is called as data privacy and data protection. Recently, Europe has come up with the GDPR, as Sir was saying, the General Data Protection Regulation. Same goes with India. India has recently come up with Personal Data Protection Bill. Though it is still under process, but when it will come out, the number of jobs for this particular domain will surely going to rise. And for that, the requirement will be of engineers. So what are the job profiles in this particular data privacy and data protection? Next, please. So to comply with the regulations, many IT companies are having, the multinational IT companies are having exposure to European countries or American countries. So for that, the GDPR is applicable. This particular regulation is applicable. So engineers will be required to comply to that. For that particular thing, GDPR compliance analyst is the role which will be the most important role in the coming future. Same with the PDP compliance analyst, that is Personal Data Protection Bill compliance analyst. Here, the engineer or that particular candidate is supposed to safeguard both customers' data as well as the company's data. Some other job profiles which will be very much in demand will be the data protection consultant, who will be given by the big four companies, then the data privacy managers, data administrators, overall management of data, that data leakage should not happen. So these are some of the job profiles in the data protection domain, which will be in demand. And for that, engineers will be required. Next.
Career opportunities. After going through all the domains of risk management, I'll talk about which all companies they can target. There are the life insurance companies, health, general health insurance companies, health insurance companies, reinsurance companies, any company's risk management department, public sector bank, market risk, credit risk, liquidity risk. All these banks are doing. Private sector bank, they have 100 of risk managers, risk professionals, information security professionals and all. Everything, they have an app. Everything happens on mobile banking. Who creates that? Who ensures that the entire transaction which is going on should be secure? Engineers, risk professionals, regulators, pension fund regulatory development authority, PFRD, NPS is under, they are handling that profile. Regulators, IRDI, RBI, lot of job requirements are there. Lot of certifications they are asking for. And like I have cleared my CERISC, Certified Risk and Information Security Control exam from ISACA US. Many of these regulator job profile, they ask for this certification. Consulting firm, Big Four, Deloitte, KPMG, Ernst & Young, PwC, Protiviti, they want IT firms spoke about Accenture, Cogni, Infosys, because why? Because they are creating divisions for the insurance companies. US insurance companies, their information security, who is handling? Engineers in these IT firms. But what happens after certain years of experience, they get to know about this domain, they clear certifications of US, UK, India, and then they go about this. Almost all type of companies who are having risk management department, as risk management discipline is applicable to all industries. And with post 2014, the country, our country is very much changing. It's changing to a compliance-based country. Everything gets very, very structured, reported to a regulator. Wherever there is no regulator, regulators are coming. And risk management, as per the corporate governance guidelines of various regulators, is made mandatory. So all industries, all companies are going to have a risk management department. There we have a lot of scope. And these are the some other profiles where engineers can get a lot of responsibility. Operation risk manager, risk consultant, business continuity manager, information security analyst, enterprise risk manager, what Aniket is, fraud manager, fraud monitoring manager, through softwares, through analysis of the pattern, scenario analysis, you can get to know what type of frauds is industry is going to face. Site risk assessment. Lot of sites are there, all sites. What has happened yesterday in Vishakhapatnam? A risk management failure. Lot got died. We lost a couple of lives over there. Site engineer, site risk assessment was not done proper. Maybe he is not from an engineering background. Insurance program manager. What type of insurance cover we should be having? Yeah, Nikit?
Yeah, so this site risk assessment or the risk engineering aspect, property risk assessment, for all these type of job profiles, the civil engineers, chemical engineers, mechanical engineer, production required. Because they are the better person who can assess the particular, identify the risk or assess the risk. Because they are having the domain knowledge. Like for example, a chemical factory. A chemical engineer and a mechanical engineer, production engineer will be a better person to identify the risk associated with that property. So opportunities are for every type of engineering field. Yes, sir, please.
Yeah. Similarly, there are others like operation risk modeling. Through risk, we are doing modeling, creating softwares, creating products, how to model a risk. All depending on the engineers, statisticians, actuarians, we are dependent on them. Incident response unit, risk control unit. ISO Aniket spoke about 27001. Apart from that, there is 22301 business continuity management system ISO, where engineers are required. 31,000 ERM auditors. 31,000 is an ERM enterprise risk management standard. We require a lot of scope is there. Risk analytics, legal risk. What type of legal we are exposed to? These are the profiles, a risk professional having a background of MBA, engineers are very much in demand. So with this, we'll talk, who are we? Generally, it's that we talk, who are we? We wanted to relate you guys, who are we? After this slides, I am Sidhyanshu Sharma. I'm RIMS US India Liaison Officer and member of RIMS India Chapter. Vice President in Risk Management at SBI Life Insurance, having 14 years of experience. And I started as management trainee in SBI Life after my MBA. And then with these qualifications of C-Risk by ISACA US, CRMP by RIMS US, Associate in Risk Management, Enterprise Risk Management by Institutes US, Fellow of Insurance Institute of India, Associate in Life Management Institute, Associate in Reinsurance Administration, Customer Service by Loma US, Cyber Risk Management, Managing Cyber Risk by Institute US, and other ISO's qualification, I became Vice President with experience and with these certifications. Now I take care of entire enterprise risk management for SBI Life, business continuity management for SBI Life. There are a team of 24 employees who reports to me. And the total department size is near to 45 in SPLI only. One company I'm talking, there are other companies as well. I'm also a trainer and guest faculty in a number of B schools like NIE, BIMTech, Institute of India, and wide variety of audience I've trained, regulators, MBA students, senior risk professionals, international delegates I've trained. And I'm a member of Board of Studies of NIA Pune. That's why I'm able to relate this, that what is there in NIA Pune, that maximum of their 90% of their MBA are having an engineering background. So that's why we give all type of risk engineering subjects, ERM subjects, risk modeling subjects. So they should be having all these exposures, at least in the MBA, and they can join after MBA to the industry. And it speaks a lot about risk management, information security in national international conferences. I spoke to all the CROs, chief risk officers of BNP Paribas Cardiff at Hong Kong last year. And now I want to create a pool of skilled at risk and Infosec professionals in Asia. That's why I'm here. I'm very thankful to Talent Battle to invite us, myself and Aniket, to talk about this in detail, to tell us with our experience what all we are getting, what all the gap we are facing, and why engineers are very much required to see here also. Rather than seeing this segment after a decade of their career, let us start now. Let us start just after engineering, the first, just get some certification, get to know about all this and try for this. There are a lot of scope, lot of LinkedIn profiles are open even now when I'm talking, not to joinees also, even to top management. Head risk management openings are there. Just browse LinkedIn, you'll get to know. Similarly, Aniket, he's also from MBA from NIA, having an engineering background. So that's why he's a stopgap arrangement for my team. Whenever there is a requirement, I use to transfer him in a very short time period that you have to do this, you have to do that. He gets bogged down also sometimes with a lot of pressure of the work, but his knowledge, VP and VDI, everything he handled for the entire around 17,000 employees of SBLI, 930 branches, he handled. Got him done through him. That is his profile. Aniket, talk about yourself.
Yeah, sure, guys. So currently I'm responsible. I'm working as a manager in enterprise risk and business continuity in SBI Life. I have over 4 years of experience in this. Now talking about the qualifications, I have completed certified risk management professional by Risk Management Society USA. Then I'm an associate in risk management by the Institutes USA. I'm a fellow member of Insurance Institute of India, Mumbai. And then few other ISO certifications I have completed, like for example, the 31,000 Enterprise Risk, 22301 Business Continuity, ISO 27001 Information and Cybersecurity Management. Yeah, so please.
Okay. So great, guys. Thank you so much for such a valuable information. Our students ultimately need to understand there are a lot of job opportunities for engineers after completing the degree. And even for those who are right now working in, maybe those who are having 2 to 3 years of experience, they are also having the job opportunities. Rather than just focusing into one particular direction, there are other directions also in which they can have a great growth. So I would like to tell everyone that we are going to start with a certified course, okay, on this particular domain. Now, what I would like to initially say, maybe Shibyanshu sir or Aniket can start with the details of this course. Then I'll be taking some of the doubts like which kind of job fresher can get different branches. Aniket has already covered that, but I'll be taking those questions again later on, and about the criteria part also, whether there are any criteria. So first of all, I would like to tell again everyone, we are going to start with a certified course on enterprise risk management, business continuity, information security, and data protection. That will be live classes, which will be conducted by Shibyanshu sir and Aniket. So Aniket, if you can give more information that what exactly we are going to do during this session, that will be helpful. Or yes. Sir also.
Yeah, Aniket, start.
Yeah, so guys, we are launching with this particular course. This course mostly will be taken on the weekends, so it will be as per your convenience. We'll teach you in detail what this discipline is all about. Like for example, the enterprise risk, information and cybersecurity data protection. What we have given you in this particular presentation is a very high level overview. Just to get acquainted with, we have just given you a small details about this in this PPT. But in this particular course, we will teach you in detail. Like for example, in case of enterprise risk, right from the identification of risk to the monitoring of the risk, how it is to be done. Then in the business continuity, what are the principles, components, how to develop the business continuity plans. In information security, what are the important factors, how to implement information security framework in the organization. What organizations are expecting with the information security engineers. In case of cybersecurity, what are the important factors to be installed in the organization. Then in the case of data protection, what are the principles or what are the software tools which are required to safeguard both client data as well as the company data. So we'll teach you in detail. All these four aspects we'll teach you in detail. This will be live classes on the weekends. At the end of this particular course, student will get the course certificate. We are there to solve all your doubts, maybe through emails or following sessions.
And placement assistance will be given. The placement assistance in terms of various networking of ours. That will be given. I'll tell you about a case study, what we have faced in last few days, that there was a requirement of a business continuity team member in my team. I wanted an engineer because a disaster recovery site was to be handled, data recovery site has to be handled by that person. We were searching for an engineering background person having some exposure to disaster recovery or business continuity. In Mumbai, we were searching. Nothing we got. We went to Pune, nothing we got. Pune, Oxford of East, nothing we got. Maharashtra, nothing we got. We finally got a lady in Bangalore working in Amazon. We hired her. She's an engineer from Thapar Institute of Technology, Patiala. She's an engineer. An engineer from North working in Bangalore, and we got her here in Mumbai. No assistance is there. No networking is there. Engineers are not aware of this. Nobody is telling them about all this. So which all companies like me, other professionals are also having this issues. They're talking to us. We refer them, and there is a lot of this is happening. Job switching is happening. In my business continuity profile, I'm getting a lot of every other year, that person is going to another company with a very good hike and all, because there is a lot of demand. Supply is not there. So that's why create a pool. There should not be such a high demand and low supply. We want that to be filled, this gap to be filled by talent better.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Now I have opened the chat box, everyone. Okay. So maybe if you're having doubt, you can directly ask. Later on, I'll be sharing the link of the course as well. All the details about the content, and Shibhanshu sir and Aniket, they are going to conduct these particular sessions on the weekends, which will be helpful. Now, one by one, let me cover one part again. You will be getting a course completion certificate, and the placement assistance part is important. Now, those students who will be conducting or who will be going through that course successfully, those who are able to understand the knowledge, only certificate is not important, that you need to understand. You just go through the session, and if you get a certificate, that is not enough. The knowledge is also important. So then we can start with the placement assistance also. Now let me take some of the doubts. Okay, everyone please pay attention. First doubt is, suppose sir, can you tell the engineers who belong to maybe mechanical, civil or non-CSIT background, what kind of job requirements or how this particular course will be helpful for them? Anyone of you can take.
Yeah, Aniket spoke about some domains, right. Risk engineer, plant insurance managers. There even information security, a background of that. We require such type of engineers. I spoke about Thermax, my friend. He wanted a person from a civil background for his plant in Pune. He's a ERM head. He wanted somebody from a civil background. A lot of scope is there. Okay. Not only like CS and all, they are very much in demand in information security and data security, but for insurance manager, for business continuity manager, for plant engineer, risk engineer, risk analyst, we require civil engineers and all.
So the course which we are going to conduct, that will be helpful for them as well, like non-CSIT background students.
Yeah, it will be very, very much helpful to them.
So do they require a coding background as well? Because most of the non-CSIT students won't have coding background. Maybe they are having a gap also of 1 year or 2 year, and they are looking for the job opportunities. So without having a coding background, how it will help?
I think as such it is not required because these are fairly different concepts. All the concepts that we'll be teaching in ERM, BCM, InfoSec, cybersecurity, and data protection, it will not be coding based, first of all. Though it will be highly technical concepts, but it will not require the coding experience or coding knowledge as such. So basically, this particular course is for all types of engineers. All branches can appear for this.
Anikit, continue.
The domain which I have told you, or the job profiles which I have told you, that are strictly for the non-CSIT background people. The plant manager or the site risk assessment or risk engineers. But when we say this overall, when we say about ERM, BC or InfoSec cybersecurity, it is for all type of engineers.
Okay. If you're having any doubt, you can just mention in the chat box, everyone. I have opened it. Now, one more doubt I would like to ask, like, how these particular opportunities will be shared with the students, like whatever placement opportunities which we are going to share, or right now how it happens in the industry whenever there are any opportunities. Security or maybe risk management, how students come to know? Are there any off campus taken directly, or how it happens?
Generally, it is happening through LinkedIn.
Okay.
And in HR consultants, they have the companies, they refer these candidates. We get to know. Then networking also, because actually there are less engineers right now in this domain. So networking plays a big role. That's why a lot of attrition is there in all the companies. People used to tend to jump because they are getting good packages in competitive companies and all. So that's why it's more about networking, LinkedIn, and HR professionals.
So maybe we can say one of the main reasons why engineers are not able to apply for this job is they are not even aware about these kind of opportunities.
Yeah, they are not aware. They are not aware. Lot of gap is there in their awareness.
Okay. Now, one more doubt which I would like to ask on the behalf of student is about the criteria. Whenever they apply for any companies, maybe like multinational companies from engineering background, okay, usually there is a criteria of like 60%, okay, for engineering or maybe 10-12. So, whenever they apply for these kind of job roles, is there any criteria?
Aniket, you take.
So, as such, there is no criteria. Like, for example, the one which you have mentioned, that 10th, 12th or engineering aggregate 60. So as such, I have not seen any criteria. But yeah, again, what are the things which are surely required? Highly technical domain knowledge.
Hmm.
If they are able to prove that they have the knowledge, skill sets required, I don't think there will be a challenge in getting the job.
Okay.
If a company is just to add one point, if a company is very well, big company, top company, a listed company like Infosys or SBI and all, there is maybe some criteria like 60% in your 10th, 12th.
Okay.
If the company is very big, if the listed companies are there, if the company is not that big, if it is again a service provider to the big companies and all, there should not be any criteria.
Okay. Can you mention about the growth also? Suppose if any particular our student starts with our course, and then suppose if he gets a job in a company with this particular role, how his like overall growth will be in career?
I'll give an example of a service industry. That person who is just an engineer with knowledge of this domain, they join as senior associates like that designation. In a 2 years time, they get one first promotion, becoming assistant manager, then deputy manager, manager, senior manager, chief manager, associate vice presidents, vice president, senior vice presidents. Like this is a career growth for them.
Okay.
One more example I will give. So the chief information security officers or the chief cybersecurity officer, in most of the companies are engineers.
Yeah, true.
That is the head of info. CISO is a head of even the DPO, officer, All these are majorly engineers only.
Okay.
So engineers can expect that the growth will be in terms of, let's say, CEO or head of ERM, head of business continuity, or lead business continuity, director data protection, something like that.
Okay. Can you just go to the next screen? So some students are asking about the fees, so I can mention about it and then I can take some of the doubts. Yeah, so first information, everyone, the batch is going to start from the 25th August. The fees, total fees are 10,000, including taxes. But today, those who are going to pay, okay, will be providing discount. Can you just go back to the previous screen so I can mention? Yeah, thank you, sir. So today, those who are going to enroll, they will be they need to pay 9,000 rupees. There is a flat 1,000 rupees discount. And this particular discount is only applicable for initial 25 students. Now, Aniket or even sir, I would like to ask you one thing. Since the fee is like around 10,000 rupees, what are the usual fees which are right now there into the market? Like maybe the similar kind of roles? Or are there any similar kind of opportunities or platforms which are providing these courses?
I cleared Cirrus Kisaka. For that, I'm a member of Kisaka and I'm paying around 15,000 per year for becoming member of Kisaka only. And then I wrote examination Cirrus, which was near around 45,000. So, and then I have to maintain this certificate every year. I have to give another 10,000. So that is for a year, this is a total output touching to near 60,000-70,000 to get the entire knowledge domain of Cirrus Kisaka. Similarly, there are other examples which Aniket will give focus. Aniket.
Yeah.
So any international, any good international certification course in information security, cyber security, or data protection, it will cost you minimum of 25,000. This amount can increase, this amount can go up to 50,000 or more than 50,000 also. For the information security, the ISACA is the global well-known institute of USA. The average cost of their certification, each certification is somewhere somewhere 50,000. Other certifications, like for example, the ARM from the institutes, it will cost around 1 lakh of rupees. So majorly, the certification course in these areas, them around 25 to 50,000.
Okay. Aniket, there is one doubt related actually to sir. The doubt is about the course which we are taking and the one which you mentioned about the 45,000 price. Okay. What is the difference they are asking? Is it more about the examination, right? When they can do, when they want to grow into the career?
Yeah, it's more about the future development. Even after this also, if they join any risk management vertical, I would suggest them to write 3 years, 4 years down the line these courses to get an international exposure what is happening. The right. Major criteria, they cannot write these examinations right now because they require 3 or 4 years of experience. That is a mandate required by them. Whether it be RIM-CRMP, whether it be Cirrus Kisaka, whether it be CISA-ISACA, everything, they require a background of 3 to 4 years of work. So they are not eligible right now to write, but subsequently they should write because what happens, they'll get to know what is happening. How the hackers, what is ethical hacking? What type of attacks is happening? From where attack is happening? How to code deception technology, softwares and all? How to make these? These are the knowledge they get. So they should be writing those examinations down the line, but not right now they are not eligible because they are just engineers.
So I guess Prasad, that doubt is clear between the difference. Our course is like basically you can say starting with the all information and understanding the concepts. Once you do that, you will be starting with any company, you will be doing a job and maybe after 2 to 3 years, it will be easy for you to do those examinations. Okay, get quick growth, we can say in a career. Now, one student is asking about the course duration.
Yeah, Aniket.
Yeah, so the course duration will be of around 1 month. So when we say 1 month, basically it will be 4 weekends.
Right.
So Saturday, Sunday. So like this, 4 weekends.
Right. Okay, and all the details are already uploaded on our website. I'll be sharing that link in some time. Now, let me take the next question. Like the same Prasad is asking that he's a fresher 2019 pass out and he's mechanical engineer. okay, like here, so that means he has graduated last year, okay. So he's asking about the job opportunities, like whether he can join this particular course.
Certainly, Ajinkya, certainly. He can certainly join. He can leverage this course. He can get to know this course. One good thing about this course is that other course which are available in the market, basically they will just give either one domain, either it will be information security or business continuity. But all the best courses which are available in the market, we are taking all the major domains. We are taking ERM also, we will be taking BCM also, information cybersecurity also, and data protection also. So, okay. The best of the best we will be providing.
Okay. One more doubt is about, like, what is the usual salary which students get once they do these kind of courses? Like, how, what salary base is there from which they start?
That again depends on the company. If the company is big enough, they are listed companies, stock companies, they start with a package of 5 to 6, 7 also. If the company is a smaller one, but growth opportunities is more, startups are there, they'll give you less, but they may give you a very good growth and ESOPs and all, they will give you subsequently and all. Like this, they can arrange for all this. So it depends on the company. Based on the company to company, it varies a lot.
Okay, I would again like to clear one point. We have mentioned about placement assistance. So can you tell in detail what exactly we are going to do? Because to make sure that we are keeping it clear with all the students, like what exactly we are going to do.
With placement assistance is that through our information networking in this industry of risk professionals, risk management, all friends who all are in touch with us, who all want to hire engineers in their team, but they are not getting, we will refer them to them if they have understood. Because after referring, they will not be taken just because of our reference. They'll be taken because of their knowledge, which they will have to develop through the course. They have to understand this. That's why, Ajinkya, you told also that they have to be very, very vigilant. They're doing their entire training. They should be very, very expert in this. Because we have taken one person, the example I gave, of Patiala Engineering College, not only because she was an engineer, she had a background in business continuity and so on. That's why she had an exposure of that, and she was working, so she was aware what is BIA, how to do business impact analysis. She knows what is MTPOD, maximum tolerated period of disruption. She knows. That's why. So these terms and this, how to handle this, we should be knowing. And this reference, LinkedIn reference. And many networking skills will be assisting them to have a placement. We are not giving them a guarantee that they will get a placement, 100% guaranteed what many B schools tell, but we will definitely give them assistance.
Yeah, definitely. No one can give 100% placement guarantee, because only joining the course is not enough. I would again like to clear knowledge, with all the students, the knowledge which you are going to take, we are also going to take various tests during that particular course. So that score will be also important, okay, whenever we are going to refer you for various companies. So one student is asking, after completing this course, do you provide another platform for placement? Prasad, it will be more like we'll be referring you once you do the course, once you go through all the test series which we are going to provide, and based on that score we'll be referring the students. Okay, this is not about 100% guarantee. This is about more, you can say, assistance. Those students who are performing really well during the course will be providing that opportunity, because there are already a lot of opportunities and there are not many students who know or who are aware about this. Okay, any other doubt, guys? One student is asking, how good is CISSP certification? How good is CISSP certification, and which courses should be taken? So is it related to you, sir? Because
It is related to information security. Aniket, you explain this in detail.
Yeah, CISSP is again one of the very technical certification, but again it will require a good amount of work experience. So what I suggest is that CISSP is here for CISSP. One should undergo at least 2 years of experience, because at the time of writing the exam, he will not be able to get the knowledge because he has not done any kind of actual hands-on experience. He is not having hands-on experience. So my suggestion is, if you want to, he or she want to appear for the CISSP certification, at least 2 to 3 years of work experience is mandatory.
Right. So again, I would like to clear some things, guys. The batch will start from 25th August. The fee is 10,000 rupees. If you decide to register today, it will be 9,000 rupees. Both the industry experts, Shibhanshu sir and Aniket himself, will be going through all these live lectures. They will be teaching you, and the test series will be also provided. And based on your score, job assistance will be given. You can even compare with another industry courses also, which are there on other platforms. So if you feel, if you want to start with a career, or if you even want to change the, what I can say, the domain, this can be the best thing. I would like to just tell one thing, everyone. This is not more about 2021 batch students, okay? This should be more applicable for already graduate students like 2020 or the previous batches. So for third year students, I would recommend maybe you can continue with your graduation right now and you can join our next batches in future if you want. But more about the students who can join immediately, okay? So that thing is clear. What is the time period of the course during weekends? One student is asking. It will depend like 2 to 4 hours depending on the content on that day. We'll be giving you all the information prior once you join that session. One student is asking, there are so many courses, but job opportunity is very less. What is your suggestion about it? So as sir has mentioned, sir, do you like to take this particular question?
Yeah. Risk management, there are not many courses which is a link to ERM, business continuity, information security, cyber security, data protection. Data protection is still in the very new stage in India. So there is not much courses linked to this, especially for the engineering domain. So an engineer having this qualification is a very rare combination, and they'll get a good scope in job market.
Okay. One student is asking, can 2021 batch students join? You can join, but right now, whenever you are going to get a job assistant, that will be the next year. Okay, so if you are having interest in this particular domain, definitely you can join. We will be more than happy to guide you in this particular domain. So 2021 batch students can join, but if you are having immediate campus, on-campus or off-campus activities, then you can join the next batch as well. Okay, it depends on you whether you are having interest in this. This is more about, we can say, those students who are actively looking for the job opportunities and they are not right now getting the job opportunities, since and they are having the skills. So this particular course will be really a good booster, we can say, for them. Any other doubt, guys? Any other students? If you're having doubt, you can tell me in the chat box so I can ask. So I guess a couple of doubts we have already cleared about criteria, about the different branches students can apply, along with the knowledge, like not only certification, knowledge is also important. So if you're having any other doubt, you can just message us in this particular like chat box, or later on you can contact us on our website as well. One student is asking, is this certificate helpful to get the job? Because some companies required international certification like CCNA or CEH.
True, certified ethical hackers and all, they require, there is a demand of that. But this certification will give them a scope. What is all about? So this, I'm not telling that we will be competing these international certificates, right. But again, these international certificates require work ex. You cannot take these certification as just working, writing engineering papers and you're writing these certifications. A lot of work ex is required. So even for clearing those certification, this certificate is very much required, because they'll get a knowledge. They will get the entire knowledge, and this can be a stepping stone for them to clear these international certificates.
Right. So Mayuresh, I can say you cannot directly compare our certificate with international courses which are already recognized, but this can be like a stepping stone. So whoever is taking your interview, they will come to know that you have gone through a detailed course, you have a knowledge, and that will be definitely helpful. Yeah. Any other doubt? Anything else you would like to mention, sir?
This much only, I just request all of you to just explore yourself in this new domain. Explore yourself. Don't take COVID as a challenge. Take it as an opportunity. Take it as an scope where the entire industry is changing. We can also change. And change is the only thing which is constant. So keep upgrading yourself. Keep upskilling yourself, and it will help you. I'm telling you all. Thank you.
Okay, just I'll be posting the attendance link in the chat box. Okay, So I have posted the link. If you have already submitted that link previously, then you don't need to submit. What I will do, the link is actually big. I have added the link in the description box of this particular video. So later on you can go. Let me just post the link of this particular course. Okay, so you can go on the website and you can check. I have posted the link. One student is asking, I'm a graduate of 2021 batch, when the next batch will start. If you want to join this batch, you can join. Okay. The next batch right now, we have not planned. We have planned this batch. Like this is the first batch. We are checking like how it works out. And then the next batch will be launched. Certificate link is in the description of this particular video. So you can go, there is a registration link on which you can click. Okay. So I would like to now end this particular session. I guess I have covered all the doubts. One student is asking, do we get certificate for attending this informative session? Yes, you get. You can just go to the description of this video. You will get a link, okay? And you will be getting a certificate till Tuesday. Just give us 2 days. We'll be providing you certificate. Don't worry about it, okay? The students who are interested to enroll for the courses, whatever doubts you are having, you can just message us on the website. We'll be more than happy to cover your doubts. This particular domain is new, so definitely you will be having some doubts, okay? We'll be there to cover your doubts, okay? So thank you, everyone. I would like to thank Shibhanshu sir and Aniket sir, okay, for this wonderful knowledge, valuable knowledge which they have shared, because this is a new thing, new experience for the students where they can start their career. So I'm really grateful for you.
Grateful. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, Ajinkya. Thank you, Dalmatel. Thank you.
Yes, I would just end this. Just give me a moment.